As plans for a major new infrastructure bill stall in the Senate, President Biden is meeting with a key Republican negotiator while his allies in Congress grow increasingly impatient. Let's discuss this and more with the chairman of the very important Budget Committee, Senator Bernie Sanders of Vermont. Senator, thanks so much for joining us. As you know, Republican Senator Shelley Moore Capito said she was encouraged after her meeting today with the president, but we got no specifics on whether there's any common ground. Is it time, in your opinion, Senator, to call it quits, to move on without Republican support?
Well, Wolf, according to the American Society of Civil Engineers, the guys who determine the state of our infrastructure, what the Republicans are bringing forward is about 10 or 15% of what we need to rebuild our roads, our bridges, our water systems, our wastewater plants, not to mention affordable housing, not to mention the health care crisis, the child care crisis, the fact that so many of our young people cannot afford to go to college. So I think that the time is running out. And I think that what we have got to do is, working with the American people, understand that real wages in America have not gone up in the last 40 years. Half our people are living paycheck to paycheck. Almost all new income and wealth is going to the people at the top 1%. Now is the time to pass a budget which works for working families and the middle class and not just the wealthy.
The Republicans say they're on board with a lot of President Biden's plan when it comes to what they call traditional infrastructure, roads, bridges, airports, stuff like that. Are you and other progressives denying President Biden potentially a bipartisan win by including all of the other issues that you're labeling as infrastructure that Republicans say it's not really traditional infrastructure?
But Wolf, what I'm saying is, according to the experts in our country, the American Society of Civil Engineers, what the Republicans are proposing for traditional infrastructure is only a fraction of what we need. I think every American understands that our roads and our bridges, our water systems, all of that is really crumbling before our eyes. I'm a former mayor. And what I know is that unless you invest in infrastructure, it's only going to get worse and it's only going to be more expensive. We now have the opportunity to create millions of good paying, often union jobs, rebuilding our infrastructure. What the Republicans are talking about is totally inadequate.
Do you want to do away with the filibuster right now so that legislation is passed in the Senate with a simple majority as opposed to the 60 votes that you need when the filibuster is enacted?
Well, given the enormous needs facing, you know, working class people in this country and the middle class, we have got to go forward aggressively. Now, in the best of all possible worlds, we would have at least 10 Republicans who understand that people can't make it on $10 an hour, that we need good paying jobs, that our young people have a right to a college education, not leaving school deeply in debt, that we are the only major country on earth not to guarantee health care, that we pay the highest prices in the world for prescription drugs. In the best of all possible worlds, you'd have 10 Republicans plus 50 Democrats who say, yeah, we got to go forward. Unfortunately, Wolf, and let's lay it out on the table, we don't. I doubt that you have one Republican, let alone 10, who are prepared to do the right thing. And if that is the case, of course we have got to go forward within the Democratic caucuses, 50 votes plus the vice president. There was just a report that came out today that talked about how significant it was that those direct payments, those checks, $2,000 in checks we got to working people, what it meant to so many millions of people in this country. And if Republicans don't want to cooperate and help us address the crises facing working families, yes, we have to do it with 50 votes through a reconciliation package.
Let me get your quick reaction while I have you, Senator. Israel's opposition parties have now reached an agreement that potentially will oust the Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu after 12 years in office. How significant is this?
Well, it is a very strange coalition. They have people on the left, people on the right, people in the middle. So we will see what happens in terms of that coalition. But it is no great secret that I am not a great fan of Benjamin Netanyahu. I think over the years, the coalition that he has put together has become more right-wing, and in some cases, part of that coalition is overtly racist. So I will not be mourning the departure of the Prime Minister, Mr. Netanyahu, and I hope that Israel will have a government that we will be better able to work with.
Yeah, there will be a first time an Israeli Arab party, the Ram party led by Mansour Abbas, who's part of this new potential coalition. We'll see how that unfolds. Significant development indeed. Senator Sanders, thanks as usual for joining us.